Welcome back. You're still watching Urban Today. Thank you very much for joining us. Now, you can go to our socials at Urban TV Uganda, at Lynn UG3, at Seka Henry, that is on Facebook and Twitter as well, and be part of this discussion. And right now, I'm joined by Grace Nabakoza, Head of Employment Relations and Legal Federation of Uganda Employers Association. Oh, no, not association, employers. It ends there. Right, what are we talking about? We're talking about employers and unemployment in the country. This is a federation of employers, okay? And we are seeing there's a lot going on in that area. They are the employers. The employees come here and make noise. The employers are also there making their own noise. But today, Grace, welcome to the show, and a good morning to you.
Good morning to you too.
Right, where do we start from? Let me see. Unemployment, this is my biggest concern.
Yes.
Because the current unemployment rate stands at 9.2%. You as an employer's federation, what are you doing about this?
Thank you very much. The Federation of Uganda Employers, like you have rightly said, is an employer's organization in Uganda. But we play also a role in terms of creating employment for those that have graduated or those that are really due for really employment. So our role is basically simple, is first of all to ensure, because you know we are having a problem in skills mismatch. You find I have graduated, but the employability skills that the employer needs, I do not have them. So we have now largely engaged with the Directorate of Industrial Training, UBITEB, to ensure that potential employees are reskilled, or even those that are actually in employment continue to reskill themselves with either soft skills to ensure that there is continued employment for them, but also opportunities for them. So it is about continuing to skill and reskill those that are already in employment, mm-hmm. to ensure that they go up the ladder higher. But also, like you have seen, the president ensuring that there is continued industrialization and continued employment. So the struggle goes on. It is not a one-off thing that jobs are created once and for all, but as also people ourselves,
right.
Yeah, the labor, we have those gaps that we still have to address, that employers are finding a bit of a challenge.
You mentioned that the Federation is involved in creating opportunities, yes. which is fantastic. Then you're also trying to address the issue of skills mismatch,
yes.
By involving the different organizations, stakeholders in this case.
Yeah.
Employability. Of our graduates, what is the problem? Is it because we see that after graduating they are applying for different jobs day in, day out, but they somehow they don't make it,
yeah.
meaning that after not making it they give up and they just either sit home or come up with ideas or something. What is the problem? Why is it that there's a huge employability problem?
I do not know where to start tracing the problem from, but
you as employers,
yes,
definitely
but us
have
as
identified.
Employers, it starts from the kind of courses that we take, or the kinds of courses that are offered in our different institutions.
Mm-hmm.
We find that we are a bit more theoretical than practical. Yet employers need a blend, mm-hmm. Of both being theoretical in nature, but also what more skills am I going to add to his team,
right.
when I join. So you find that the labor or the graduates that come out of the universities are then not able to get employment. So again, we encourage, how about we start up with our own ideas, okay, as labor to be able to start up our own businesses that we then link to already these established, and then we can, you know, learn from one another and then kickstart. So the problem is really in at the point of either the choice that I make on what to study,
mm-hmm.
or the institutions themselves, but that is already being addressed by having these other institutions that are teaching technical
skills.
And skills, yes, to be able to blend. Because every employer would be concerned, if I'm recruiting Grace, what more is she adding to my team?
Yeah, because my concern really is, if you're the Employers Federation and you have identified these gaps, I would expect that you go forward and maybe address these issues to the concerned stakeholders.
Oh yes,
to make
that is
a
happening.
Change.
Yes, that is happening. That is happening. We're not saying that we have known where the problem is and we're not doing anything about it.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, we are, because most employers, again, are heavily engaged in reskilling their staff.
Right.
Now they take the responsibility on themselves and know that, yes, my employees have gaps, but I cannot just tell them go away. Let me just heavily invest in training and reskilling them in a more professional and a more practical way, so that they have these skills both for work but also for their own personal gains, yes.
That's right. Still on that issue, because you mentioned employers, definitely when they sit down, this, maybe if I should remind you viewers, is that this federation has been in existence for 60 years. And it says it is a premier voice of employers in Uganda. My concern is, if all employers have identified the issue of curriculum, the issue of being more theoretical than practical, what strides have you made to change that? Are your hands tied on that area?
No, our hands are not tied, but you know, changing curriculum does not happen overnight.
That's right.
Yes. So in development of new curriculum, for example, we are on the board of Uganda Directorate of Industrial Training. We're also fully represented on the UBTEB. So at that point, that is now where we influence largely on what is it that employers really need to do. But we also have our statistics, because we have so many employers who have had really so many issues of us being theoretical all the time. And
that's
theoretical,
true.
Yes. So in those spaces where we go to, even at the Ministry of Education, we are largely involved as employers to be able to make our input and know that once these courses are offered, then, yeah. But of course, those that have existed over time, you cannot just wake up one day and say, they are scrapped off or they are removed now.
That's right.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, the Ministry of Education has made strides in adjusting the curricula.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Now, away from that, let's talk COVID-19.
Yes.
Employers and COVID-19. We saw many people being laid off. We saw companies closing. I think some of them are still struggling and they're limping. As an employers' federation, why didn't you come up to the... What did you do? People were struggling, were crying. We lost our jobs. But the employers were like, okay, why didn't you show up at all?
We did show up. Probably we didn't come to Urban TV, but we were in print, we were all over the place
during that period.
Mm. So basically for us now is to engage our employers. Because it was a situation where you are torn into two. And then as an employer, we were encouraging to find, first of all, other softer means of handling employees. Because we saw a situation where this COVID has come, but it will certainly go. But you will still need these employees at a certain point in time.
Yes.
So for us, to the our employers, we provided advisory, okay? But also guidelines on how to do particular things in regards to our employees.
Mm.
Yes. So most importantly was, first of all, to do an assessment on your business.
Okay.
Do you want to reduce, or some of them actually still need their employees? They told them, please go on. You can utilize your annual leave, and by the way, it is with the employee's consent. We encouraged a lot of dialogue with the between the employer and the employees to be able to implement something that is going to be workable, but also to avoid situations of litigation because you don't just wake up and just say, don't come back tomorrow. So for us, it is the employer, sit down and dialogue with your employees. What is more practical for you? But like we said, there are employers who are already limping at that point in time. Like they had no option but to actually go to the extremes of saying, guys, we have to just let you go. But in terms of letting employees go, then the provisions of the law have to be followed.
As we wind up this discussion, the Federation of Uganda Employers is celebrating its Diamond Jubilee. And the theme, Employers' Journey of Impactful Practices for the Sustainability of Jobs. My question as we conclude in 1 minute. How are you as employers working hard to sustain jobs? People's jobs, because we need them badly.
So to our employers out there, we encourage that you have business continuity plans, because that is the only way you can be able to tell that, yes, I need these kinds of jobs and these kinds of skills, and then we can now have a dialogue on where are these skills found. Is it at the university? Is it in technical trainings? Is it in TVET or BTVET and things of the sort? So for us as the employers, is we want to walk a journey where we are not abandoning and saying, oh yeah, we are employers, but also we are not creating jobs. We don't want to have a situation of that kind. So it's first having your business continuity plan. Where are you and where do you see yourself moving forward? And then you are able to tell that these are the kinds or the right labor or right skills that I need from my staff.
Thank you very much, Grace.
You're very welcome.
And we wish you the best on your Diamond Jubilee celebrations. But I want you to take this message to our employers. Pay attention to employees as well. Thank you very much.
You're very welcome.
Thank you for watching Urban Today. My name is Lynn Komujisha, and of course, I was with Henry Sekanjako. We'll definitely catch you again tomorrow. And do take care of yourselves.